think that you are our master and lord. Well, Claude Billon received his medical degree from the Medical University of Bordeaux in 1979. After a graduation of human cytogenetics in 1976, he then studied pediatrics and has been the clinical assistant director of Bordeaux University in the Department of Pediatrics, Neonatology, and Intensive Care since 1983. He currently serves as a pediatrician in the neonatal unit of the Children's Hospital of Bordeaux, as a scientific manager of Bordeaux Marmont Human Milk Bank, as a lecturer and head of research in neonatal nutrition in the Medical University of Bordeaux. His particular interest in research led him to graduate in biology and health in 1988 in Bordeaux, Aquitaine, be awarded a master in statistics applied to clinical research, and in Montreal, Canada, and complete a philosophical doctor in nutrition and food science. Along his career, he has often been invited as a guest profession specialist in nutrition and neonatology in various universities abroad, Montreal, Corrientes in Argentina, and I can add to a lot of society, even the Spanish Society of Pediatrics in Madrid. Over the last 35 years, he has been an active member of different scientific organizations, either in French, European, or American, specialized in perinatal medicine as neonatology, pediatric, and nutrition. In this instance, he has served as the president of the Association of Pediatric Education in Europe since 1928. And behalf APE, he is member of the European Academy of Pediatrics. He has also been very involved in the French Human Milk Banking Association for more than 10 years, sharing for academic knowledge focused in nutrition and his long clinical experiences in neonatology. He's currently carrying out several researches in the composition of human milk. As an expert in nutrition and perinatal medicine, he is also author on several numerous scientific publications. I must underline his apportation to the link between the nutritional states of pregnant and newborn. And I repeat, for most of pediatricians linked to nutrition and to education, our friend Claude is our master and lord. Thank you. Okay.
Yes. I begin with my slides.
Okay.
Pardon?
Okay. I can share your slides if you would like.
Yes, I use my slides.
Sure. Okay, I'm going to share my screen.
Hi, okay.
Okay.
Michel, c'est pour moi. Okay. Dear President and colleagues, it's a pleasure for me to talk about pregnant and lactating women nutrition. We have been contacted by Journal of Health Care, MDPI, as guest editor to produce a special issue, The First 1,000 Days of Infant, with six papers free of charge, instead 1,600 Swiss francs, plus one free for the best abstract for a young doctor, and 50% waive from 8 to 13 articles, so 800 Swiss. We will choose with priority the speaker of AP Virtual Congress, and I propose you if you want to develop your talks, to write an article on healthcare journal. In our developed Congress, the principal problem is the excess of feeding and high BMI or obesity. However, we risk have problems concerning essential fatty acids, oligoelements, and vitamins, which could need supplements. And we compared in different dietetic survey difference between these results and recommended diet allowance. Nutrient excess or deficiency play a role on the development of infant and even adult or epigenetics that Virginie told. During 30 years, our team studied diets of women during or not pregnancy and lactating, but particularly fats with measurement in mother blood cord and blood cord, adipose tissue of mother during cesarean.
Dr. Cloud, I think you can't control your slides, and just tell me to go to next slide anytime you want, okay?
Ah, okay.
Okay, thank you.
Escape. Okay. The next slide.
Okay, next.
The next slide.
Yes. And this okay. Slide?
Yes, it's good.
Okay.
We studied blood, mother blood and cord blood in the birth. Adipose tissue of mother during cesarean, composition of breast milk, and we underline the variability of this composition in different countries. The next slide, please. The tissue cost of pregnant women is 80,000 kilocalories per 250 days. So 300 kilocalories plus than in pregnant compared to non-pregnant women. It's a mean, but it's depending of BMI. Next slide, please. This is important to have a first visit of the pregnancy early to evaluate the BMI because the energy intake will be different with high or low BMI. We will talk about the needs of normal BMI women who need about 300 kilocalories. But it's not the same with the stage of pregnancy of first trimester, no supplement of calorie. The second trimester, about 200 kilocalories, and the third trimester is about 450 kilocalories. But for group of Colesco, say no more 10% of total energy. It's different. Next slide, please. The needs in minerals, calcium, about 200 milligrams per day in plus 200 milligrams per day, iron plus 30 milligrams per day, zinc about 18 milligrams per day. Next slide, please. It's by comparing what exists, food consumption studies on the one hand and the needs recommended by the nutrition committees on the other, that we can try to answer this question. We have used a few demonstrative dietary surveys, an American survey, WIC, about 500,000 women, and two French surveys, one supported by PAPOS, about 500 women, the other by LISERF, 550 women. We compare the results of these different surveys with the daily recommended intake of the French Nutrition Committee. Next slide, please. Comparison between pregnant and not pregnant macronutrients are the same, and there is an excess of total fats, protein, but not enough carbohydrates. Next slide, please. Next slide. The fats on triple destiny for the fetus: energy, storage, and neurosensory development. Saturated fatty acids, what is the different category of fatty acids? Saturated fatty acids have no double bond. Monounsaturated fatty acids have as one double bond. The principal MUFA is oleic acid. Polyunsaturated fatty acids have plus than two double bonds. LC-PUFA, long chain polyunsaturated fatty acid, plus 20 carbon chain. Next slide, please. Breast milk, as you see on the slide, intake all the type of fats, but vary with mother fat diet. Olive oil, intake only linoleic acid, is an incomplete intake if you use only oil. Canola oil, intake both linoleic and linolenic acid is more convenient. Meat, eggs, fish bring arachidonic acid. Oily and lean fish brings DHA. Next slide, please. Pregnant and non-pregnant women intake too much saturated, not enough polyunsaturated, and moderate trans fatty acid, which is bad fatty acid. The next slide, please. Diseased infant's brain shows the increase of arachidonic acid and DHA from 22 weeks of gestational stage in fetus to 2 years postnatal. And this supports the neurodevelopment of infant. It's very important to intake DHA and arachidonic acid. Next slide. This, the PUFA needs for brain for the fetus and the total need in preterm of 6 months gestational age is about 45 milligrams per kilo per day, as underlined lapidium. Next slide, please. Polyunsaturated fatty acid comme mainly for the placenta. Through a biomagnification process, the placenta will transfer more long-chain buffer acid, arachidonic acid, and DHA than polyunsaturated fatty acid, precursor linoleic and linolenic acid. This is our results who confirm the other results in your study. Next slide, please. In adipose tissue of pregnant women preloved during cesarean, pregnant women have major content of saturated fatty acid and monounsaturated fatty acid. There is a bad ratio linoleic on linolenic acid 32 and excess of omega-6 fatty acid. It's in 1997, but today is very modified. Next slide, please. Different oils, only canola oils, soja, nuts contain omega-3 and omega-6. But olive oil is unbalanced, contain only omega-6. Next slide, please. Fish and mainly oily fish intake DHA. The mackerel fish is more rich in DHA. You can also eat lean fish, but there is less DHA. Next slide, please. Where can we find these famous long-chain fatty acids in our food? In fish fat for DHA, in eggs, meat, and eggs for arachidonate. It's considered to varying the oil, rapeseed, olive, and eating fish are sufficient for a good lipid nutrition balance. Next slide. Recent studies have suggested that TFAs, trans fatty acid, alter polyunsaturated fatty acid metabolism. Our study is according to done by Colesso, as reported that in premature infants, the level of plasma trans fatty acid is inversely correlated to long-chain polyunsaturated fatty acid levels. An inverse correlation is also observed between trans fatty acid level and birth weight. This suggests that exposure to high levels of trans fatty acid during pregnancy may impair fetus growth. Next slide, please. The T-fatty acids are found in bad fat and white bread and pastry made with bad fats, which are consumed very high in USA and Canada, which in 1997 has the level the most elevated, about 17% of all fatty acids are TFA. In France, we are on the 2% only in 1997, and only 1% in 2014 and 2014. Next slide, please. Polyunsaturated fatty acids, they are essential. Also, there is sufficient intake in far too rich in linoleic acid provided by sunflower oil and olive oil and deficient in linolenic acid, the ratio linoleic on linolenic optimal is 5 to 6, so that the precursors are more easily transformed, but few transform into long chain fatty acid. Next slide. Mineral salts, trace elements and vitamins. Next slide. Is it possible to balance the need for mineral, trace elements and vitamins with a diet as previously defined? As the recommended calcium requirement is 1200 milligrams per day. A small supplement of 200 milligrams of calcium is needed. This can easily be met provided we drink more milk, but this will provide more protein and more saturated fatty acid. There is a slight deficit compared to recommendation in magnesium, 150 milligrams per day, and iron, about 15 milligrams per day, in total of 30 milligrams per day in pregnancy. For zinc, there is a shortfall of 10 milligrams. The usual recommended requirement is 15 milligrams, and diet provide only 5 milligrams. Next slide. What about vitamins? A balanced diet provides only 1 microgram, 1 or 2 micrograms of vitamin D. And in countries where it is not sunshine, the requirement is about 15 to 20 micrograms per day. Group B vitamins, while vitamin B1 and B6 are moderately deficient, if we consider that folate, vitamin B9, requirement are 500 micrograms, there is a risk since the average intake is 255 micrograms. Next slide. In total, with a balanced diet, the needs in protein, lipids, carbohydrate, energy are covered. On the other hand, the intake of calcium, iron, vitamin D, and folate remain insufficient. Next slide, please. Nevertheless, medication is sometimes necessary. In severe nutritional anemia, iron and B vitamin should be prescribed to supplement a balanced diet. It is also a good idea to add a dose of 200,000 units of vitamin D at the beginning of the third trimester of pregnancy to a balanced diet in addition to a nutritional supplement. Next slide. Next slide, please. It is true that breastfeeding women has spontaneously balanced her nutrient intake for the child she is feeding. Since a man has been able to perpetuate himself up to that point, but the micronutrient and vitamins intake is not. Next slide, please. But the micronutrients and vitamin intake is not always perfectly guaranteed. It seems necessary to take care of this breast milk adequately provides all the macronutrients necessary for the harmonious growth of the child. The composition of breast milk, protein, carbohydrate, vary little according to the mother diet. On the other hand, its composition in lipids, trace elements, and vitamins is eminently variable with the mother diet. Next slide. The lipids composition of breast milk vary greatly with the mother diet. A mother who is exclusively vegetarian will have a milk richer in fatty acid of the omega-6 series, linoleic, whereas Eskimo women consuming exclusively fish will produce a milk very rich in fatty acid omega-3 series as DHA. Next slide. We carried out 24-hour dietary surveys in 1997 in 18 women giving their milk to the Bordeaux Lactarium using Fridor software, PHRC study in 2014 of 80 women survey for 3 days of diet survey. We just compare women in green survey for 3 days and in we compare the existing with the recommended nutritional requirement in blue. The existing with the recommended nutritional requirement defined by the French Committee of Nutrition. Macronutrients, the diet of breastfeeding women in 1997 was hyperprotein, about 100 grams per day versus 80 grams for recommended. Hyperlipidic, about 130 grams per day versus 90 grams recommended, and often insufficient in carbohydrate, about 205 grams per day versus 340 recommended, and 2,700 kilocalories per day, which is hypercaloric in 1997. In 2040, in yellow, normal protein, normal lipidic, and hypocaloric is better, but there is maybe not sufficient in carbohydrate. Next slide, please. Fat, too much fat. In 1997, 100 grams per day. And the 43% of the energy versus 32% recommended with an excess of saturated fatty acid and a deficit of polyunsaturated fatty acid, 5% versus 7% recommended. Next slide, please. Essential fatty acid, not only is there a very low intake of essential fatty acids, linoleic, about 11 grams per day versus 15 recommended, and 3.8% versus 6% polyunsaturated. But above all, linolenic acid is 0.35 grams per day versus 2.8 recommended, also 0.2% versus 1.1575 to 4% recommended. With a very high linolenic ratio in 1997, 32 versus 6 recommended, which will lead to a deficit in transformation of linolenic into DHA. Next slide, please. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. There is a great variation of DHA and arachidonic in human milk with different countries. You can see that in USA, there is a few intake, a few level of DHA in the milk. And on the other end, you can see in maritime China, there is 2.78% of DHA. In France, there is about 0.32% of DHA. And arachidonic acid is very similar on the countries higher than DHA in major country, but not in Japan and maritime China. Next slide, please. Carbohydrates. In terms of foods, sweets and pastries are consumed in excess by more than half of the mother. Bread, 90 grams per day versus 250 grams per day recommended. And starchy food, about 160 grams per day, are avoided and lead to a lack of fiber and slow sugar. Next slide, please. Finally, the drink must be abundant, 2 liters. In our study, the last study in 2014, it must avoid sweetened fruit juice, which is consumed with excess, about 150 milliliters per day versus 100 milliliters recommended. The category of vegetables and fruit is important for dietary balance as it provides minerals, vitamins, and fiber. We observed a low consumption of raw vegetables, 20 grams versus 100 desired vegetable, 140 grams versus 250 recommended, and fruit only 160 grams versus 300 recommended. Next slide, please. Protein requirement. No, next slide. Next slide. Protein requirements are covered by the normal diet. There is even a tendency to overconsume. mainly in 1997, too much about 90 grams per day, and in 2040 is 72 grams per day. It's less, but the intake recommended was about 1 gram per kilo per day, so 60 grams per day. In terms of quality, the intake of animal proteins with a high biological value must represent at least about 70% of the intake, which is the case in the French surveys. The remainder can be made up of vegetable protein. Animal proteins are represented by dairy protein and the one, and but also by meat, fish, and eggs. Vegans have proteins with a bad biological value and a deficit of vitamin B2, B12, D, and micro elements requiring a supplement. Next slide, please. Far too much meat in 1997, 190 grams versus 150 grams recommended, and not enough fish. Only one mother over 18 had eaten fish. Moreover, we can remember that 2 eggs and 60 grams of meat are enough to cover daily needs. Meat, preferably lean, red or white, is a source of protein, but also of iron in M form, which is easily absorbed B vitamins and arachidonic acid. Fish also provide very long chain fatty acids of the omega-3 DHA, and it's advisable to eat them at least twice a week fish like mackerel, about 170 grams two times in the week. Next slide. Mineral salts. Calcium intake is very important. In fact, the production of 800 milliliters of breast milk leads to an additional need of about 300 milligrams of calcium. 6 times out of the over the 18 mother, there is an insufficiency of milk consumption and therefore of calcium, but also of magnesium, 250 milligrams per day versus 480 milligrams recommended. Less zinc is only consumed 7 milligrams per day versus about 18 recommended. Next slide, please. Vitamins. There is a real interest in suggestion vitamin supplement in view of the insufficiency of vitamin D, 2 micrograms versus 20 micrograms recommended, vitamin E, 7 milligrams versus about 12 milligram recommended, B6 1.5 milligram versus 2.5 recommended, and folate B9 folate is consumed about 130 microgram versus 500 recommended. Next slide. In total, with a balanced diet, the needs in protein, lipids, carbohydrates, and energy are covered. On the other hand, the intake of calcium, vitamin D, and folate remains insufficient. Next slide. Balanced diet plus nutritional supplementation improves the coverage of oligoelements and vitamins, except for vitamin D, which can be supplemented with each day 1,000 unity per day. Next slide. What is this proposition? It's not mandatory. What is the optimal menu for a breastfeeding woman? It is a balanced menu providing proteins in the form of dairy product, 300 milliliters of semi-skim milk, one yogurt, one portion of cheese, no more than 150 grams of lean meat, slow sugar will be provided by potatoes, bread, and cereals to the detriment of rapidly absorbed sugar. Which oils? This is the originality of the diet that we recommended. Little butter, only 10 grams per day, and oils, I prefer about 25 grams of rapeseed oil or canola oil and margarine, about 20 grams. Next slide, please. It is true that the pregnant woman has spontaneous balance her nutritional intake for the child she is carrying, since man has been able to perpetuate himself up to that point. But the micronutrients and vitamin intakes is not always perfectly guaranteed. It seems necessary to ensure this for the well-being of the fetus and the mother. We can imagine a new concept of milk for pregnant women, which added with optimal supplement. Also, we have to use supplement vitamins and oligoelements outside of a milk. It would seem desirable that every pregnant woman, pregnancy, vegetarian, teenager, socioeconomic problem, who is a risk group, should be able to benefit from a consultation with a dietitian from the maternity ward at the beginning of her pregnancy in order to determine for each of her dietary pattern and, if necessary, the appropriate nutritional supplement and energy. I thank you. Excuse me for the lecture, but I have too much slides.
Thank you very much indeed, Claude, for this talk, so founded, so documented, and so interested for in this mare magnum of supplements indicated for very, very sources. I think it your talk has cleared the basic foundation of the supplementation of minerals, of vitamins and vitamins, and of polyunsaturated fatty acids. Thank you very much. Questions?
Yes, I have two questions, if it is possible. Thank you, Claude. It was an amazing speech. I'd like to ask you about only fish in the diet. I think that you recommended twice a week, if I understand the slide. What about the fact that it may be polluted by metals, and because for a few years now, I am an obstetrician, and we have recommended to our pregnant women to be careful about salmon and the excessive consumption of those oily fishes.
Yes, I think that you speak about the risk of mercury.
Yes.
My counsel is to consume about between 200 milligrams of DHA, but I prefer 300 milligrams of DHA intake by mackerel, but because it's the less expensive fish, and the more content of DHA. In our study, we give one box of portion of mackerel, 150 grams twice a week. I think that the risk of toxicity is less than the lack of DHA. So if you want, you can consume one a week of oily fish and one a week of lean fish. It's also good.
Okay, thank you. And another question. Yes. Maybe it's to open a door which is yet open. But do you think that we should think about establishing a diet program to be known by the mothers before the delivery, before the birth, because mines are more available during the few days after delivery, and for the women to think about it and have an habit to buy the food that they need and to avoid food which is not good, and to write this program and with the perinatal webs to diffuse it very largely in France, because I think it's not done yet.
Thank you. I think that there is a continuity, not between the pre-birth, between in the before the birth, the pregnancy, it's very important to know the BMI. Its BMI is higher than 30. You have to not increase 300 calories per day supplement of energy. If you you have to diminish, you to decrease this supplement, not supplement. And if you have a BMI less than 18, you have to increase the supplement. That I have exposed is for normal BMI between 18 and 25. It's very, very important to have a consultation between before pregnancy,
preconceptional, before conception,
and it's very important to have a dietitian who work only in the maternity to counsel the feeding to all pregnant women, not only the ill pregnant women, because the dietitian are not so there is not dietitian time because she cannot counsel dietetic in the normal normal pregnant woman.
Thank you. Any question more? Any more questions?